Hello, friends. Sheep farming is gradually becoming a strong economy in many countries around the world. Tens of tons of sheep meat are consumed every year, helping to increase sheep export turnover. So how do farmers around the world raise sheep? And how does sheep wool processing and meat harvesting take place? Here is the video. So if you and your friends are interested in such an issue, feel free to share this video with all of your friends right now so that you can watch it and enjoy it as well. Sheep are familiar animals in the livestock industry. They're cared for and raised the most in some of the world's leading countries. Based on statistics from the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United States, FAO, the leading countries and the number of sheep livestock includes China, Australia, India, New Zealand, Iran, South Africa, Sudan, and Argentina. Around the world, large-scale sheep farms sometimes raise millions of sheep. Mount Hope Station is a farm in New Zealand with a scale of 1,300,000 sheep. Clare Valley Station in Australia with 1,200,000 sheep. And Miranda Station in Australia with a scale of 900,000 sheep. The process of caring for and raising sheep requires attention and in-depth knowledge. The breeding stage is important, depending on the purpose of raising animals such as meat, milk, or fur. Sheep are raised on forage and concentrates and are protected by regular vaccination and deworming. During the farming process, changing the bedding regularly, approximately every 10 to 15 days, helps maintain a clean and dry environment for the sheep. Dry straw is used as a lining, providing warmth in winter and coolness in summer. Feeders installed throughout the sheep area help ensuring the sheep are conventionally provided with food. They are made from wood, plastic, or metal, and placed away from feces and urine. Daily intake includes grains and bran, with foods such as wheat, corn, oats, rice bran, corn bran, and wheat bran form a farm of 100 sheep. About 300 to 400 pounds of bran and grain are needed per day. The time when the sheep are released outdoors is usually in the early morning and cool afternoon, depending on weather conditions and breeding purposes. Major countries around the world are making continuous efforts to develop the sheep farming industry to meet the market demand and at the same time ensuring the best care for the sheep. Sheep's wool, a valuable resource in the textile industry, is typically harvested in spring or summer when the weather is warm and dry. At this time, the wool is fully developed, providing the best quality and is easily trimmed. The process of harvesting sheep wool on a farm requires care and technique. The first step is to select the sheep. Animals that are mature, healthy, and possess thick, smooth wool. This ensures that the resulting wool will meet quality requirements. The tools that are needed to harvest sheep wool includes shears, and brushes. The next steps are shearing the sheep, a delicate process that requires dexterity so as not to damage the sheep's skin. After shearing, the wool is cleaned with a brush to remove dirt and twigs. Then, the fleece is classified by length, fineness, and color. To serve different purposes in the textile industry, this process ensures that the final product will meet the needs and requirements of the market. The amount of sheep wool harvested depends on many factors, including sheep breed, farming conditions, and weather. On average, an adult sheep can provide from 9.92 to 44.09 pounds of wool per year, depending on care conditions. Currently, world sheep wool prices ranges from $2 to $10 per pound, creating a diverse and a flexible market. The sheep wool is not only an important source of raw materials, but also an important export item for many countries around the world. The largest sheep wool exporting countries include Australia, China, New Zealand, South Africa, and India, contributing to the world sheep wool exports, which are expected to reach about $100 billion in 2023. Among them, Australia stands out with a turnover of about $30 billion, holding the leading position in the world. The largest importers of sheep wool today includes China, Japan, South Korea, and the United States, all of which plays an important role in promoting the development and providing resources for the global textile industry bridge. After harvesting the sheep's wool, preparing it and sending it to auction is an important process that requires careful care and management. Once harvested, the sheep usually takes about 2 to 3 months to be prepared and put into the auction process. Transporting should be done carefully to ensure the sheep's comfort and avoid injuring them. The transport cage is designed to provide comfortable space and keep the air healthy. Each auction can bring in large number of sheep, depending on the size of the event. Sheep auctions in quantities ranging from a few hundred to a few thousand sheep. Before going into the auction process, the sheep farm is carefully prepared. Farm staff needs to be trained in transporting and caring for sheep. Before entering the auction area, sheep are fed, watered, and rested to ensure health and comfort. Upon arrival at the auction area, the sheep are arranged in order in the transport pen. The auction process usually lasts 1 to 2 days, depending on the number of sheep participating and the size of the event. The price of the flock of sheep usually is about 10 to 15 sheep, depends on many factors such as sheep breed, meat quality, and auction time. On average, such a flock of sheep costs from $10,000 to $50,000. The auction process ends when all the sheep have been sold and the highest bidder becomes their owner. This process is not only a commercial event, but also an opportunity for farmers and contractors to meet, exchange experiences, and find the best quality sheep for their farms. Preparing and processing lamb is a complex but important process to ensure food quality and safety for consumers, from health checks and full vaccinations of sheep to meat handling and storage. Every step is performed with care and professionalism. The processing begins when the sheep are brought to the processing plant, where they will undergo health checks and vaccinations to ensure meat quality and consumer health first. The sheep are then prepared for stunning using electricity or CO2 gas, minimizing pain for the animals. The next step is the skinning process. where the hair and skin are removed to produce clean, quality lamb. The internal organs are also removed to ensure food safety and prevent any negative impact on meat quality. After completing the previous steps, the lamb is cut into different parts such as ribs, thighs, and shoulders. Subsequent processing includes washing the meat, marinating it with spices, and preparing it for packaging. The lamb is then packaged and stored in cold conditions to keep the quality of the meat maintained every day. A processing plant can process thousands of sheep, meeting the growing market demand. As of 2023, lamb prices in the U.S. ranges from $5 to $15 per pound, with worldwide consumption reaching about 60 million tons. It is expected that by 2024, this number will increase to about 17 million tons, with a total production value of about $100 billion. The sheep meat market is currently a potential market with a steady growth rate. Consumer preference for lamb is driven by its richness in protein, healthy fats, and other key nutrients. In particular, lamb is widely popular in many countries around the world, especially in the European countries. My dear audience from Australia and Asia, if you find this video interesting, please comment number one below to let us know right now. Thank you so much for watching the whole entire video. See you again. Today, commercial fishermen use large vessels the size of football fields and advanced electronic equipment to catch fish. These ships are capable of operating at the sea for up to 6 months, storing thousands of tons of fish in giant freezers, creating conditions for fishermen to catch large amounts of fish every day. The reel system will release the trawl into the sea after determining the area where the fish are. The easily recognizable point here is the area where many seabirds fly. This area has a lot of fish, and they are forming dish columns. These large ships do not require human labor to cast and pull the nets. The spindle will be started to harvest fish nets. Tons of fish, after being pulled up, will be harvested into the ship's compartments. The fish net will use clean water to move the fish and clean the fish before entering the process stage on the ship. Then the ship will be divided into vertical trays in the ship for freezing and packaging. Each package of fish will be stored in the frozen deck. In addition, the fish will be processed and canned right on deck. It'll be cleaned, and the head and the internal organs will be removed. After being cleaned, the fish will be divided into segments and canned. Each box of fish will be processed similarly to that in modern processing factories. They're also stored in frozen warehouses before being brought ashore. The trawl method of harvesting fish has reached an estimated 40 million tons of fish per year. According to research, The livestock industry has existed for thousands of years, but the fishing industry has only exploded in the last 50 years, and it has been changing dramatically from small family boats and limited-sized nets to today's giant ships and modern fishing techniques. People apply science and technology to locate locations with large fish yields and limit bycatch of rare protected creatures such as turtles and seals. Population growth leads to ever-expanding consumer demand, thereby increasing seafood fishing. Perhaps many people would think that fishing boats are designed the same, but in reality, fishing boats all have functions, and not all are created equal. Each is designed and built based on their intended use, water depth, size of fish they are pursuing, trip length, weather, crew size, and the type of fishing gear will be used. It all comes down to the design and function. Different fisheries have their own preferred methods, and these differences in intended goals and objectives have given rise to a wide variety of fishing methods around the world. Fishing at the sea has become the main source of income for many generations of coastal fishermen. Whenever there is a sea, there is fishing activity. Every year, humans catch about 80 to 90 million tons of fish per year from the ocean. This huge number increasingly reflects overfishing, which is causing marine resources to become increasingly depleted. Therefore, conservation efforts are critical to ensuring the health of ocean ecosystems and the long-term survival of fish as a food source. When harvested, the sea fish will be processed right on the ship and put into a frozen storage compartment. After the large ships arrive, raw materials from the sea will undergo processing and packaging before reaching consumers. Processing plants with modern lines and machinery are an important step in the food supply chain. The processing process includes removing fish internal organs and cleaning thoroughly to ensure product quality. For those who want special fish, the packaging process can be changed according to the dealer or consumer requirements. Shockproof boxes and vacuum bags ensure that the fish remains as fresh in quality as when it was first caught. Automatic machinery not only helps increasing production efficiency, but also ensures food safety and hygiene.
Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. So since we don't really have any clue of what kind of difficulties that you could be facing in your farms, please don't forget to share all the problems you're facing and obstacles you're going through, as this will tremendously help us with our upcoming videos.